Let us discuss about sedimentary. Sedimentary titration. In this sedimentary titration, the titrant is cesium sulfate, and let us draw a diagram for this. Before drawing a diagram, let us write a reaction. Fe plus 3 reacts with cesium plus 4 will form Fe plus 3 plus cesium plus 3. This is a reaction. Fe plus 2 reacts with cesium plus 4 will give Fe plus 3 plus cesium plus 4. Now let us consider electrode potential. Complete E is equals to electrode potential of indicator minus electrode potential of reference. E is equals to electrode potential of E naught of indicator or E naught of reference. Now let us consider E value for iron. E of Fe is equals to, there is a formula, E naught of Fe minus 0.0591 by N log Fe plus 2 by Fe plus 3 minus 0.28. This is a formula for electrode potential of iron. Is electrode E naught of Fe minus 0.059 by N into log Fe plus 2 by Fe plus 3 minus 0.8. This is the formula. Now this formula can also written as E naught of Fe plus 0.0591 by N log Fe plus 3 by Fe plus 2. This Fe plus 2 by plus 3 becomes Fe plus 3 by plus 2 minus 0.28. This is E naught of E of Fe. And let us consider the same for E of Ce. It can directly written as E naught of Ce plus 0.591 by N log Ce plus 4 by Ce plus 3 minus 0.28. It is about electrode potential of cesium. Electrode potential of cesium. Now let us consider a diagram. In burette, we need to take cesium sulfate, and in conical flask, we will take iron solution, Fe plus 2 solution. Now, let us consider case number 1. Let us consider the case number 1. This Fe should be 20 ml in conical flask and it is 50 ml of cesium sulfate. In case 1, add 10 ml of CeSO4 into Fe plus 2 solution. Add 10 ml of CeSO4 into Fe plus 2 solution. Now it becomes, now let us consider ratio of Fe plus 3 by Fe plus 2. Fe plus 2 is 100 and Fe plus 3 is 10. And whenever the cesium sulfate is poured into the Fe plus 2 solution, it becomes Fe plus 2 will get converted into Fe plus 3 and it is a reaction. This is the ratio for Fe plus 2, Fe plus 3 and Fe plus 3, Fe plus 2. Please. Reaction of Fe plus 3 by Fe plus 2. After adding this 10 ml, this Fe plus 3, it is 100%, it becomes 90% and Fe plus 2 is 10%. And let us apply this here. It is equation 1. Equation 2 and E naught of Fe is 0.77, E naught of Ce is 1.41, E of Fe is equals to E naught is 0.77 plus 0.0591, n is 1 and log 9 minus 0.28. Now log my 1 by 9 value is minus 0.95. now 0.77 plus this 0.059 into 0.95 is 0.714. It is 0.714. And by total summing this, we get 0.714. That is E of Fe. Let us consider complete E value. E is equals to E of indicator minus E of reference value. E of indicator is 0.714 minus reference value is 0.28 is equals to 0.41. E is equals to 0.41. This is the first case. In case 2, add 50 ml of cesium sulfate into Fe plus 2 solution. Now the ratio becomes Fe plus 3 by Fe plus 2 is equals to 50 by 50 equals to 1. Now, by applying this value in E value, E of Fe is equals to 0.77 plus 0.059 1 by 1 log 1 to 0.28. Log 1 is 0. Log 1 will be 0. So 0.77 minus 0.28 is equals to 0.49. This is case 2, and let us consider case 3, when 90 ml of cesium sulfate is poured into Fe plus 2 solution, ratio becomes 90 by 10, that is 9. Now apply this in the formula, that is E of Fe is equals to 0.77 plus 0.059 1 by 1 log 9 minus 0.28. Log 9 is plus 0.59. Now 0.77 plus 0.095 is equals to 0.82. This is E value. If you want total E value, this 0.82 minus 0.28 is equals to 0.54. This is case 3. In this way, serometric titrations is useful in case 1, case 2 and case 3. Here the endpoint can be detected. This is about serometric titrations. Next titrations is iodometric titrations or iodometry. In iodometry, titrant is iodine, and the indicator which is used is sodium thiosulfate or starch. In burette, we should take sodium thiosulfate. The principle of this iodometry is iodine will get converted into 2 moles of iodine, 2 moles of I minus. This I minus is weak oxidant. Now this weak oxidant will react with strong reducing agent. Reaction with strong reducing agent. Strong reducing agent, first one is SN+2. Reacts with 2 moles of I2, resulting in the formation of SN+2 plus 2 moles of I minus. Second one is S2O3 minus, will react with 2 moles of iodine, will form S4O6 2 minus and liberate 2 I minus. And these are the reactions with strong reducing agent and reaction with weak reducing agent. that is first one, arsenic plus 3 is reacted with I2, resulting in the formation of As plus 5 plus 2 moles of iodine. Sb plus 3 reacts with I2, resulting in the formation of Sb plus 5 and 2 moles of iodine minus. Now, let us draw a diagram for this iodometric titration. Now, in this burette, we should take sodium thiosulfate, and in this, we need to take iodine solution along with indicator. Along with the indicator, and whenever the iodine which is present in this will be in I minus form, and the iodine will get here, iodine will get reacted with indicator, iodine will get reacted with indicator and forms blue color. Blue color will be appeared in this conical flask whenever some amount of this sodium thiosulfate is poured into the iodine solution. Poured into I2 solution, then this S2O3 will react with indicator and remaining I minus ions. Now this blue color will convert into color plus. It will get converted into colorless. Whenever the blue color will get converted into colorless, note the readings in this burette and it will be the end point. This is the iodometric titrations. In iodometric titrations, direct iodine is used. Next one is iodometry. Difference between iodometry and iodometry is here the indirect titration. It is like indirect titration, and here titrant is Cu plus 2. Now, and indicator is starch, and in burette the titrant is Na2S2O3 should be taken, and here in principle, iodine will get converted into 2 moles of I minus, and Ki will get converted into Ki plus I minus. Now, this 2I minus will react with this I minus, will resulting in the formation of I3 minus. This is a standard one which is required for iodometry, and this iodide which is liberated indirectly will react with the analyte. Liberated iodide will titrate with the analyte. It will titrate with analyte, that is H2O3 minus will react with I3 minus, will resulting in the formation of S4O6 2 minus plus 3I minus. Now let us consider a diagram for this. In burette, we should take Na2S2O3, and in this we should take copper solution and indicator. First, the iodine which is present in this will be reacted with indicator. Iodine will react with indicator and resulting in the formation of blue color solution, and next some amount of sodium iodide will be added into this conical flask. As a result, the extra which is some amount of I minus ions will be left free in this conical flask, and this sodium thiosulfate which is poured into this will react with these ions, and this blue color will get converted into colorless. After changing this into colorless, the endpoint can be detected. This is iodometry. In iodometry, direct iodine is used, whereas in iodometry, indirect iodine is used. This is iodometry.